Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Olive. If this is the first time you're seeing this face, welcome. Please kindly subscribe and turn your notification for any uploads. If you already subscribed to the channel, thank you so much for coming back. I decided to try out this trending rubber band hairstyle, and that is all I'll be showing you guys in this video. If you want to find out how I achieved this look, then continue watching. Okay guys, so my hair is already washed and moisturized. I will go ahead to section my hair into two parts, with the back section bigger than the front. I try as much as possible to get a very straight line, even if it's usually not the case. I'll be braiding the back section first with this Lush braiding hair extension color 1x900. It's already pre-stretched, so I didn't have to stress myself with stretching it. I'll be using a total of 2 parts. I'm going on to part a single line and cut them into small square boxes before grouping the roots of my hair. How you prep your attachment by splitting the hair into a small one and a big one. Loop them around each other exactly like I'm doing and place on your fingers with your index finger coming between the big ones. Then grab your hair exactly like I'm doing and start braiding as if you're doing cornrow. Braid for about 7 times when you'll be very comfortable to hold and continue to braid. When you get to the end of the braid, split the hair into 2 and twist all the way. You can practice this on someone's hair before trying it on yours. And remember, you might not get it right the first time, so you have to continue practicing until you get it right, okay? Okay, so I'm going to show you again just to make sure I carry everyone along. Split your braiding hair extension with one being smaller than the other. Loop them around each other. Place on your fingers with your index finger coming between the two big strands. Then grab your hair and start braiding as if you're doing your regular cornrow. Braid for about 7 to 8 times until you're very much comfortable to take it forward, and then continue braiding till you get to the end of the braid and then twist it over. you've tried gripping the root of your hair and it's not working for you, it's not entering your fingers, don't worry, I'm going to show you a different method using rubber band. So if you can't really get this one, then using rubber band will be the best alternative. And by the way, I have a very detailed video on how to braid using rubber band. Check the description box for the link. Band, you need just one strand of big hair. Split the hair you want to braid into two like I'm doing and place the braiding hair at the middle. Okay, use rubber band to secure it down while giving a little tug to make sure it's really tight and secure. Securing down with rubber band, split the entire hair and attachment into three strands just like I'm doing and start braiding down. You want to make sure that you're braiding it really tight, especially if your hair is natural, so you don't have too much flyaways, okay? What the back section looks like, I have a total of 25 braided boxes. For the front section, I'll be using rubber bands and hair wax. You can use shine and jam gel if that's what you have, or any other braiding gel that won't flake. I'm going ahead to cut the hair into two sections. The idea is to have three crisscross sections on each side that will make everything a total of six crisscross sections, if that makes sense. Please pay close attention to what I'm doing in order to understand better. I'm cutting the hair into small square boxes and applying hair wax to make sure it's really neat before securing down with rubber band. If your hair is long, you can use hair clips to like hold it down in order to avoid any obstruction, okay? Leftover hair thin and smooth, you have to comb a bit and then apply hair wax on it to have that sleek, juicy look, okay? Thank you. of 6 crisscross sections, I will go ahead to start attaching braiding hair extension to the leftover hairs. There is nothing difficult or new here, sis. I'm just attaching the hair exactly the way I did at the back section, okay? And that is what I will continue doing until all the hairs are braided. You know, the crisscross section is 6 with 2 leftover hairs at each section. So I got about 12 braided hairs on these crisscross sections. And yeah, this is what the hairstyle looks like. I'm very much in love with this hairstyle because it mimics cornrow with a very cool pattern. So if you can't really cornrow or flat twist your hair, this is a very good option. And moreover, you can't always cornrow your hair. This is very unique, different and juicy. Brings us to the end of this video. I hope the video is detailed enough and you enjoyed it. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed, please help your girl. I will catch you on the next one. Bye for now. Bye.